Shall it be? Congratulations. The Lord have answered you. No more power will be able to stop you. No more altar will be able to challenge you. The God you serve will be God in every second. The God you call upon will be God in every minute. And if that is yours, can I hear your amen loudest? Somebody say, today is my day. And any power that has been born to trouble the testimony and the glory and the light that I'm seeing, that power will die prematurely. In the name of Jesus. Let's open our Bible to the book of Acts of the Apostles. Acts of the Apostles 16 verse 26. Remember, this month is a theme of speed of grace. Acts of the Apostles 16 and 26. Acts of the Apostles 16 and 26. And here I want you to go through very fast. And the Bible said, if you're already there, and suddenly, somebody shout, suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison were shaken. And immediately, that is what this month carried. Somebody shout, speed. I can't get it. Shout, speed again. The Bible said, and immediately, all the doors were opened. And everyone bands were loose. Anywhere you have been banned this month, you have set loose by fire. Any power of darkness or shame or whatever holding anybody in this month, I declare your total freedom. What's the theme of the message? Answer me speedily. Answered me. Is anybody that want God to answer them speedily? That man who they shared his testimony from abroad said he called the pastor and the pastor declared shortly, and he wasn't happy and he got angry and said, is that how you people pray there? Why was he worried about what kind of prayer is that? What he has tried with effort and strength to no avail. When he was still meditating, the next thing, he was called and said, come over here. Not only come over here, take a house. And now, take a salary for sitting at home. Ah, you didn't hear that. Take a salary for sitting at home. From today, somebody's answer is coming speedily. I don't know, but I know somebody is prepared for that result. Somebody's answer is coming speedily. He said, and suddenly, that suddenly means speedily. And we are in the month of speed of grace. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake. And so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately, all the doors that have been shut against you before this time, not some door, not few door, all the doors, you know, sickness is a door of darkness. Poverty is a door of darkness. Failure is a door of darkness. Attack is a door of darkness. Whatever is not good in your life, in your direction, is a door of darkness. But it says, suddenly, all the doors that were shut, were opened on their own accord and their hands were loose. I prophesied on somebody who need an answer speedily. Today, I speak forth to your life, your destiny. Your answer is certain by thunder. I say your answer is certain by fire. If I'm hearing you, can I hear that amen with authority? Let me tell you, child of God, that there are powers and forces that hinder answers to prayer. There are powers that want to make mockery of your answer to God. That want you to look as if you are not faithful to God. Look lackluster and rejected even all your effort and prayer. There are demons that also want to see you smile. All because they want you to know that you are not, your God cannot answer you. It happens in Daniel chapter 10 verse 2. The Bible was talking about in Daniel chapter 10 and verse 2. It said, suddenly, what happened in that place? In those days, Daniel was mourning 3 full weeks. Daniel stood for 3 good weeks. What was he doing? He needed an answer to a case. He wanted a result to a situation. He wanted God speedily. And in verse 12, the Bible was talking about, then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that discern the heart to understand and to chastise thyself before thy God, the words were heard, and I am come for the words. I have come for the words. I have come for your prayer. I have come for your prayer. I have come for your prayer. Any one of you that has set your heart to answer, to meet God for an answer to your prayer, today God said, I have heard your words, that your word of God shall be answered today. That particular request shall be answered speedily. I don't know who I'm talking ready for speedy answer this month. Who want God to manifest what he has not done from January, February, May? I decree that this month you will receive a speedy answer. You will receive a speedy result. If I'm talking to you, can I hear your amen louder like thunder? The Bible was talking about in John chapter 5 verse 5 that there was a certain man who has been bound for good 38 years. What was he doing in that place? If not Jesus that came, if not the grace and mercy of God that came, that man would have been remained bound. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity for 38 years. What could have kept that man for so many years? So was something that also wanted to be free. I am to let somebody know that door of darkness fighting your life, this month the answer to your prayer has come. The answer to your prayer has come. In 1 Kings chapter 18, 24. The Bible was talking about Elisha and the first prophet of Baal. And they were having contention. If your God is God, call on him. And the Bible said Elisha began to Baal called, and there was no answer. Child of God, can I shock you today? That many of you, your prayer are like the Baal prophet, who prayed day and night and no result. Who fast day and morning and there is no result. It's not as if you are a Baal prophet, but because the enemy has by you, that there should be no proof or sign to what you are calling upon God. And it became so. And the Bible said, when it was the time of Elisha, the Bible says suddenly Elisha called upon God, and immediately and suddenly and fastly and quickly, the God that answered by fire answered Elijah. I pray for somebody, if your amen is louder this week and today's Sunday service, the answer to your prayer is certain today. The answer to your prayer is guaranteed today. If I'm talking to you, can I hear your amen? A lot of you today who are frustrated because why? Your prayers have not been answered. The enemies have turned against you and make you look as if you are not faithful or you are not committed to God. That is not the truth. But they make you look as if God has been very far away from you. And any man that is a victim of an answer prayer suffer three things. One of them he suffered is mockery. Somebody say mockery. One. In Psalm 126, the Bible says, when the Lord turns again, in Psalm 126, when the Lord turns again, the captivities of Zion, he said it was to them that did what? That dream. That was the answers to prayer. Now, if you go to verse 4, something happened there. The Bible was talking about the hidden. What who are the hidden? Verse 4, the Bible said, turn again, I can see, oh Lord, as the streams in the sand. Read verse 3 to verse 4. Who was calling upon this prayer? The hidden. If God have not answered them before now, those hidden wouldn't come out to say, God, we want you to answer us. The hidden are people who are set to push shame, who are set to mock you. You go to church, what is the proof? You are only calling upon God, what is the result? They want to know the God you are calling. These are the hidden. Say, where is the God you are calling upon? Every day, church, church, church. Every day, fasting, fasting, fasting. And yet, no sign, no proof to show that you are calling upon God. These are the hidden. But the moment they saw the proof of God, in Psalm 126 verse 1, when God turned again the captivities of Zion, in verse 4, they asked God to, I need my own. When God answered your prayers, your enemies are forced to look for that solution. Your enemies who are laughing you, some of them have problems bigger than you, but they leave their problem and begin to mock you and begin to scorn and say, look at this one, look at that one. But because God does not answer you, they have right to think that they are right. But the moment God answer you, they want to look for the same location. They want to serve the same God. They want to answer the same God. They want to follow to that same church. I pray for somebody ready for an encounter. That God that will change your story, that will make you share your testimony, that will give you a speeding answer, you shall receive that testimony. Can I hear your amen louder like thunder? The hidden are total mockers. People that the enemy has programmed. They don't want to see you laugh. They don't want to see you happy. They announce your shame even before you. They make people feel who you are, worthless. And today there are a lot of ladies who are crying. God, when will you settle me maritally? 5 years, 4 years, 6 years. Gradually is graduating to a level that doesn't look like them. And they are even bent to say, God, give me anybody, I'm ready. That is not your story. I decree and I declare, any power that says God will not answer you in this month, I curse that demon. I curse that power. If I'm talking to you, can I hear you? Amen. There are some ladies who are afraid to go to the village. They are afraid to go and see their parents, because the moment they go home, their parents will ask them, when are you coming with your husband? Hey! He becomes a mockery. You are still like this every day. When will you stop this? It is not their fault. Something is fighting them. But there is an answer. There are some. They got married 4 years, 3 years, 5 years, waiting to see what will happen. Nothing has happened. It's still the same. Ah, they start avoiding in-laws, avoiding people. All because of what? The problem that has not been answered. And this is where the hidden comes out. The hidden wants to know, who are you? Who's your God? Look at you, who say you fast, you pray. And sometimes the hidden don't even pray, they get results. And that becomes an issue of conflict, that many are saying, God, what have I done to deserve this? Child of God, any mockery that has been put on your way, in this month of speedy grace, this place that is swallowing all manners of battles and problems, whatever make the hidden growing higher than your strength, your ability, I come here as a caterpillar without stop, without break, and any power that said no to your yes, if your amen is enough to catch what God is about to give to you, I cause that demon standing on your way to die suddenly by thunder, die suddenly by fire. If I'm hearing you, can I hear you? Amen. Paul and Silas, they were in chain, they were total bondage. The question is, if God have not answered them, the church would have become a mockery. There are situations that make God look as if God is not faithful. There are problems that comes and look as if, God, where are you? Why will you be this wicked? Why? They took the first one. We heard about James. And the Bible said they stretched their hand against Peter. And then the church came up. In this one, it will not be. Why is it so? If God has not manifested, sir, this case we are preaching today would have not been. It would have become another issue of mockery. Lift your right hand up. Anything mocking your life, under this earth, this ground, in this ministry that the Lord has put at this end time, to swallow battles and problems, to swallow strong man. And I told you that this week there's no mercy. No mercy for any man. No mercy for any woman who has been playing game with your life, your destiny. I call the ground to open and let them be swallowed. Can I hear that amen louder like thunder? Can I hear that amen louder like thunder? And I decree grace to speak for you. I decree testimony to speak for you. Anywhere you are missing out, heaven will locate you by fire. Number two, what gave the enemy force on you? Number one, I said very clearly, the enemy gives mockery when your prayer is not answered. Number two, lack of unanswered prayer, lack of fire, make the enemy to disgrace. Ask the same question of the God you are calling upon. But thank God today, the Lord have told me that there is going to be a testimony beyond testimonies. In this on night, that there is going to be testimony upon testimony. Uncommon testimonies. Those who have never shared testimony once, you are the first to share. The factors that can bring an answer prayer. One, unbelief. Number one, unbelief. What is unbelief? That is somebody not having full confidence that God can see answered him. God can answer me despite this situation. Unbelief. It happened in the book of Mark chapter 8 verse 22 and 26. Mark 8. The Bible was talking about a man that was blind in a place called Bethsaida. The man was blind, and it came to pass, and he came to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him and beset him to touch him. What happened when Jesus touched the man? The eyes were opened. But you know what Jesus told him? He said, don't go back there. I keep that word. Don't go back to that place. What does that mean? Those people from that place, they don't believe in God. They don't believe the work of God. And that was why Jesus warned, don't go there. If you go there, a worse thing will come. They will prove the miracle wrong. Matthew 11, 21 to 22. You will read what Jesus said about that place called Bethsaida. Jesus was talking about that if the work that we had done in Bethsaida, we had done in Sodom and Gomorrah, that there would have been a lot of converts today. He said, look at this.
Woe unto thee, Chorazin. Woe unto thee. What? Matthew 11, 21. Woe unto thee, Chorazin. Woe unto thee, Bethsaida. For if the mighty work which were done in you had been done in Tyre and Sodom, they would have repented long ago in sackcloth and ashes. And when Jesus said, "Woe me, curse," it means Bethsaida is a curse place. A Tyre is a curse place. If you go to Israel, they point it to you and say, "Look at that place. It's full of forest. That is Bethsaida and Tyre. Nothing has been tied there since the curse came." Why? Because they operate on serious unbelief. There are people who will question your faith. Are you sure your God can answer you in this way? Why not change your mind? Are you sure that place you are going, God is in that place? They will do everything because why? They want to shake your heart. And Jesus said, "Whoa! Today, I pray by the power of the Holy Ghost that your belief system will increase for God to answer you." I said your belief system will increase for heaven to answer you. If I'm talking to you, can I hear your amen? Number two thing that can bring an unanswered prayer: bitterness. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 10 to 11. Bitterness. You know what Saul? Saul would have not died because he wanted to die. He died because he hated David. He hated David with passion. He followed after him. He never wants to see David. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 10, 11. To whom ye forgive anything, I forgive also. For if I forgive anything, to whom I forgive it, for your sake, forgive I it in the person of Christ. What does he say? There are people who are bent to destroy you. But he said, just let them go. Don't put them and become bitter. When bitterness comes into your life because of them, you will end up dried. Bitterness attracts dryness. And there are demons and agents, physical agents, that Satan has baited to keep you on bitter life. Don't look as if they are existing. Put them out. Forgive them in your heart. You can give them distance. Does not mean you have not forgiven them. This is what he's talking about. To whom you forgive anything, I forgive also. For if I forgive anything, to whom I forgive it, to your sake forgiving it I, in the person of Christ. Verse 11. And what did he say? Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of what? Living in forgiveness releases you to breakthrough. Releases you to what? And all forgiveness make you dry and wither suddenly. And be conscious of that. Number three. I may stop in number three because of time. I may be continuing from here in the all night. Number three. Enemies of destiny can make your prayer unanswered. You saw that in the case of Daniel. Enemies of destiny. What of Nehemiah chapter 4? If you read from verse 1 to 2, the Bible said Nehemiah came with a desire to build the temple. But there were people who saw Nehemiah. This thing must not be. There are people who fight you when God is about to announce you. You didn't get me. There are people who fight you when God is about lifting you up. There are people who wish you should not sleep and wake up. There are people who wish you should not even drive a car. Not talk of getting married. Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 1 to 2. The Bible said they contended over him. But it came to pass that when Sabala heard that we build the wall, he was angered and took great indignation and mocked the Jews. And verse 2. What happened? And he spake before his brethren and the army of Samaria and said, "What do these feeble Jews? Will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice?" You see that word sacrifice? They don't know how to give. Will they give? If they do, we finish. We can't get them. Will they make an end in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of the rubbish which are burnt? Verse 3. What did he say? Verse 3. He said, "Now, Tobiah the Ammonite was by him, and he said, even that which they build, if a force go up, it shall even break down their stone wall." Somebody say backfire. He said, even that which they are going to build, ordinary breeze will bring it down. In other words, no matter what they do, it will work. Enemy that doesn't want to see you in a new level, in any dimension the heaven God has announced you, if your amen is louder, I pronounce judgment against them. In verse 4 of that place, put it on the screen, verse 4. Hear, O our God, for we are despised. We are despised and turn their reproach upon their own head. Akutu bakale kutusa. And give them for a prayer in the land. How many want you to say, God, turn their reproach on their head? Stand up on your feet, no time. Only one prayer. Those who doesn't want me to move forward, those who doesn't want my progress, God, kill them now. Are you ready to pray? Say, any strong man, any agent, any power that does not want my progress, that does not want my happiness, oh God, arise, kill them, kill them, kill them, kill them. If you are not praying that prayer, it means you are an agent. He said, let it be upon their head. Let it be upon their head. Kill them. Let it be upon their head. Are you sure you are praying the prayer? Do you want that to continue? Let it be upon their head. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Put your hand in your head. Any man or woman looking for your own head. From the scripture we read, he said, let it be. He said, for God we are dispersed. You can see the way they are treating us. But let everything they have done plan be upon their head. From today, any load you are carrying as a result of jealousy, witchcraft attack, marine attack, ancestral attack, by the speed of grace of this month, I cause that attack on you. Go back to the sender. Let it be upon their head in the name of Jesus. Let it be upon their head in the name of Jesus. And I declare your head free, 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 free. Shout the amen for the last time. You are declared free forever. This month, this week, expect a speed. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. We'll continue in our all night. Please take up your offering now.